Hello and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over conditional formatting in Microsoft Excel. Conditional formatting is really exciting because it gives you a visual way to just be able to quickly evaluate your data. Excel has really come a long way with their functionality and the extras that you're able to do. So hopefully you're excited about today's lesson. I built a spreadsheet today for ranking movies. But these are not only my rankings of certain movies, but these are also three of my friends' rankings of the same movies. So I thought we could use this today to talk about some conditional formatting. So one thing you can do with conditional formatting is highlight your data. I'm going to highlight from cell B2 all the way down to B25. These are my rankings of these movies. And I'm going to go up to conditional formatting and go to cell highlight rules. I'm going to go over several of these options today so that you can get an idea of what it's like to do conditional formatting. But the first one I would like to do is just go to greater than. So what this is going to do is it is going to format cells that are greater than a certain number. So if I just wanted to see my rankings that are a 10, I could put a 9 in here. This cell over here allows me to change the color of any cell fitting that criteria. So I can fill it with dark red, light red, a green, a yellow. It's up to you. You can choose that and then click OK. And right now my rankings will be highlighted for those that are 10. I can also highlight the same data set and go up to conditional formatting, go back to those highlight rules, and I could also do less than. So I could do anything that is less than a 7. These might be the movies I don't want to see, so I can leave those filled with dark red and click OK. So notice that I can simultaneously highlight numbers that are greater than a certain criteria and numbers that are less than a certain criteria. I could also highlight these and go to conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, and go to equal to. And right now I would like to take all my movies that are a 7 and fill them with yellow fill and say OK. So now I can look at my data and I can see that the movies that I really like are quickly highlighted in green. The ones that are not so good are in red, and the medium ones are highlighted in yellow. Another option you can do is highlight the names of the movies and go to conditional formatting and go to highlight cell rules and go down here to duplicate values. What I can do here is sometimes when you're entering data, you have duplicates without even realizing it. So right now I can pick duplicate and put it with a light red fill and click OK. And then I can look over at my data and I can see that I have two entries for Braveheart and two entries for the Matrix. So what I'm going to do is highlight the Matrix, right click and hit delete, and then highlight Braveheart and right click and hit delete. And now, if you've noticed, my duplicate highlighting has turned off because now I only have one instance. Here's my only instance of Braveheart, and here is my only instance of the Matrix, and they're no longer highlighted because they do not meet that criteria. Another thing I can do is highlight my data, go up to conditional formatting, go to highlight cell rules, and pick one that text that contains. And in this case, I'm going to do star and highlight all the Star Wars movies, perhaps a custom format. If I go to custom format, I can go to the fill tab and I can pick black as a background color. And if I go back to the font tab, I could pick white as a color and say OK. And anything that containing the word star will be filled with that format. And I can click OK. So I have some options where I can customize the colors that I want to use with the criteria up here. So once again, looking at the conditional formatting, and when you go to highlight cell rules, you can do data that's greater than, less than. You can also do a between, equals to, a text that contains. If I had some data that had dates, I could highlight certain dates and also the duplicate values. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. Now, if I go to my friends rankings, friend one, here's another category of conditional formatting that we can cover. If I select conditional formatting and go to top bottom rules, right now my top 10 items, a red fill, and say OK. And these are the top 10 values, but if you look over here, you'll notice that more than 10 cells are highlighted. And the reason that is because the sevens in here, there's more than one of them at the bottom. So if I count how many tens I have 1, 2, 3 tens. I have 2 nines. So far I'm at 5. And then I have 3 eights. And that brings me up to 8. But the number 7 is making this part of the top 10. So there will be more than 10 cells highlighted because that 7 is, they're all equal. So Excel is going to treat them all equally. Another thing, I can highlight this again and go to conditional formatting and go to top bottom rules. And I can also highlight the bottom 10%. So if I do that, I'm going to pick a different color, perhaps green, and say okay. And so now the bottom 10% of all of these numbers have been highlighted. If I go to friend 2 and highlight the data and go back to conditional formatting and go to top bottom rules, I can pick the ones that are above average. Excel will automatically calculate what the average is and which cells are above that average. If I would like to use red fill, I'm just going to say okay, and these cells are above average. So let's do a quick test on that. If I highlight all of these and I look down here in the bar, I will see that my average is 8. So what Excel is doing is it's picking any number that is the average or above and highlighting it. Let's do the same conditional formatting for the top bottom rules for the below average. Now that we know that our average here is 8, let's take our below average numbers and make them yellow and click OK. So now anything under an 8 is highlighted in yellow. So just remember that when you're using the above average, the average and above is going to be highlighted. And when you're using the below average, it's going to be any number that's below that actual average. Let's look at friend 3. Friend 3, if we go to conditional formatting and go to the top bottom rules, we can do a top 10%. So if I click on that, I'm going to use red for the top 10%. If you look over here, I can adjust the percent. Let's do the top 5% of numbers and say okay. This time I'm only returned with the number 10. If I highlight the cells again and I go to conditional formatting and the top bottom rules, I can also do the bottom 10% or more. I can change the percent. So let's do that in yellow. This time let's keep it 10% and say okay. So Excel will automatically calculate this for you. And this is a very quick way. If you have a report that's due that you want to know how to color code your products that are not doing so well or your cycle time in a production plant and you want those data points to really stand out, then using conditional formatting is a very good way to do this and make some stellar reports. What if you can't remember all of the rules that exist on the current tab that you have? You can go up to conditional formatting, go to manage rules, and right here you can see all of the rules that you have set for the current selection, which is the column that I have highlighted. You can also look for this worksheet, and you can see a list of all the rules that you have already applied to this worksheet. Say you want to get rid of all the conditional formatting that you have on your spreadsheet. You can highlight your entire range of cells and go up to conditional formatting and go to clear rules, and then just go to clear rules from selected cells. You could also have done this quickly by just going to clear rules from entire sheet. So now all my data is reset back to where it was. But I just want to show you one more really cool function that Excel will do in conditional formatting. If I highlight my ratings again, and I go up to conditional formatting, and I go to data bars, I can pick any color here. I'm going to go with the blue one, and look, over in this column, you can see that my cells now have a bar for how long that data range is or how short it is based on all of the data that is showing up in my table. So this would be a good quick visual instead of creating a whole chart to be able to use the conditional formatting over here on data bars to be able to show a quick visual of what your data is. So in review today, we went over several options on the conditional formatting menu. First of all, we went over the highlight cell rules where you had a bunch of different criteria to evaluate data, such as greater than or less than or equal to. We went over the top bottom rules that allow you to look at the top X items or the top X percent items, as well as the bottom X items or the bottom X percent items, as well as the averages either above or below. And finally, we covered the data bars that gives you a quick visual of what the dispersion of your data looks like. I hope that was a good introduction for you for conditional formatting in Excel, and I hope this is a useful tool that you will be able to use in your spreadsheets. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.